Hey folks, welcome back to me choking. Welcome back to Star Wars Jedi Academy, and as we delve into the game design and level design and overall design of this cool game, my favorite of all of the Star Wars Jedi Knight games. Is it my favorite Star Wars games? I don't know. It might be, but I'll have to actually think about that. But for now, let's dive back in. Because now we're into the third act, where things get really, really interesting. Alright. Not a new game, just into the Rift. T3 underscore Rift. God, these names. Look at this interface. It's this... I think this was the Quake engine? This was not very user-facing. So, yep. We are here. We are queer, get used to it. And now I have two lightsabers, check this out. This is really cool. And I can change styles, but changing styles basically like just switches to using a saber. And I think it's like just a regular or slightly different version of the single saber. So that's interesting that you have that option. Yeah, Quake 3 engine. Okay, yeah, that's... Let's get into it. And lo and behold, I'm seeing pits without rails. Let's throw some people in them. As I was saying, let's throw some people into those pits. So, we have, like, some cool things. Also, moves. We have some new moves. So, I have the quick spin around. So, basically, when someone's behind me, I can, like, slash behind. The flip attack is neat. So, I thought jump immediately followed by forward and attack. I think I can only do this when there's... Oh no, there it goes. Oh my gosh! Yeah, this is cool. Check out how cool this is. Oh my gosh, why didn't I check this out earlier? Force pull attack. Pull into enemy into your saber, that's good. Medium attack kata. Attack and then alt attack. Oh. Jump forward and attack when an enemy is lying on the ground, and we can do this stab thing. Cartwheel. Flip to the side while attacking. Rolling stab. Rolling stab. Oh, this is neat. Yeah, check this out. Gosh, this is like such a good register of moves. Also check out. Yeah. That's really cool. And unless I'm mistaken, check out. I have a wall jump now. I can wall jump. Isn't this cool? I love wall jumping in games. So goodbye. These are probably people with histories and memories and names, but now they're just possibly hitting the ground just now? Who cares? Okay. But yeah, so I can wall jump. I can do all these kind of like really cool tricks. Now combat's gonna get fun. I mean, it was fun already. is going to get really silly. Did he just throw himself off a cliff? Now this is how you do it. This is how you do. What does chewing the scenery mean, by the way? I've heard this a few times. No real clue what it actually means. Oh, that was bad. That was real bad. Kinda dead. And a wall jump. And another wall jump. And another wall jump. And I can't wall jump anymore. I'm dead. Okay, whoops. Alright, let's actually do what I'm supposed to do. Oh, overacting. Chewing the scenery means overacting. Interesting.
I can hardly see in this thing. It's like being a stormtrooper all over again.
You were a stormtrooper?
Yeah, but I couldn't...
There's no escape.
Yeah, come on, come on.
You can't stop.
Okay, I threw one of those off a cliff. The other one, no clue what his problem was. Also kind of miffed that I'm just like fighting dudes over here. I would like some diversity. Also, it's cool that I can throw my saber and still attack. That's neat. Isn't it neat? Look at this stuff. Yeah, I should probably take the long way down. Long way down. let me know if you ever want me to delve deep into the Goo Goo Dolls, one of my favorite bands. Because I do love me some Goo Goo Dolls. Oh, there we go. Wonder what that'd be. Oh, okay. It's not good. Now I get a super, super long jump, because now all my base abilities are super boosted. Super, super, super. Alright. I think we're approaching one of my favorite spots.
A Jedi.
Yep. Oh, I'm kind of dead. Yeah, that kind of leaves you open. Whoops. What if I can throw them up high enough? I totally can. Okay, so I kind of just need to wait this out. Pleased to be removing your thumb. Oh, he jumped right off the wall. That was interesting. Okay, well, he died somewhere. Nice! I'm guessing this place is important, but like, is that a door? I mean, there were people guarding here. Oh, see? There's marks on the floor. I can pull this one up. I mean, ostensibly? Okay, let's do the... Oh, okay, do I need to do it on this sign? Yep, that was it. Hey, buddy.
You can't escape.
Didn't need to. Haha. Checkpoint. Unnecessary wall jump. Okay. Oh, hello. To go down there. There we go. Nice. So,
how am I supposed to get over there?
What are you doing here? Stop. Let's see what you've got.
Almost made it. Oh, is there a path here?
Get back here.
Oh, the secret area. Oh my gosh, I'm so sorry. He looked like bacon. Oh, okay, I guess I can just go here. See, this... I'm really digging this kind of level design because you're basically just crisscrossing a canyon. I planned out a level in Chariot that was pretty much that. Only you and me now. Bye. I wonder if you can actually, like... That was cool. You can almost wall climb your way up there. But you don't really need to. But you could. But yeah, one of the levels I did the high level of in Chariot, the Chasm Crossing, had this general theme going. Because I think it's a cool thing. You have this great giant feature and you're slowly making your way down. And I really, really dig that kind of thing. Dig? Chasms? No, never mind. Okay, so once again, I'm kind of lost. Not too much. I guess I didn't really have to go here. Hi. What? Okay, I actually didn't mean to, like...
The Jedi are here.
Okay, yeah, just brute force doesn't always work. Let's try again. Oh, am I seriously back here? Oh, okay, no. Hi. Sorry to intrude. But I'm gonna.
This place is amazing. Seems like it goes on forever. Great. How am I gonna get down there without breaking my neck?
Die, Jedi.
That is like the soundbite of this game. Die, Jedi. Ah! Someone shooting at me? You can jump pretty darn high now. Okay, you're really getting on my nerves here. I wonder what his plan was. Beyond just annoying me. Yoink. Also, it does make it a bit tricky to evaluate where you can go now, since you can jump so high. Oh, there we go. Totally here. Find a way to protect the coffin. Oh, they're actually defending themselves. Ah, just staying outside of range. That's kind of suck. Whoops. Zigged when I should have zagged. It's so efficient. Like, it's hard to do something else.
You will die by my hand. You can't escape.
La 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 la.
You won't get far.
I know.
You can't escape.
Oh, I actually just put you on the bridge there. There we go. Now we're good. It's amazing how well this works. Also, dang, this is high. This place is pretty big. Arr. Effective.
I should reseal the tomb so no one else can disturb it.
And like a switch or something, or ah. Oh! Okay, no, these are buttons.
That should do it. Rest peacefully.
Now I need to escape from this place. Rest peacefully as this whole thing comes crashing down. I guess I made it.
So you didn't run into Tavion. That's good. And bad. At least you stopped the cultists. But we can't keep this up forever. We've got to stop Tavion once and for all.
Yep.
I've been tracing Tavion's movements over the past few months. It looks like she acquired the scepter from a collector on Commoner. Then she killed him.
Commodore, no clue where that is. Well, let's move on. Spaceport!
Stay alert on this one. If there are disciples of Ragnos at Tanab, they probably aren't just passing through.
Got it. Oh, that's right, again, another upgrade. I guess heal. Again, just... Oh, wait, I can actually pick... Yeah, I'll take the RPG and the big explosion gun, because I don't really use the regular guns. Everything is so huge. Why is everything so big?
Well, this is where the captain saw the cultists. Doesn't look like...
See... Don't do this with subtitles. I hate it when games do this with subtitles, when they cut off the subtitle. So you know by reading ahead that the character is going to get cut off. The only game I've seen that doesn't do this is, I think, the original Borderlands, which actually has the full subtitle of the line the character is supposed to deliver, but it gets cut off very quickly and they just remove the subtitle. And I think that's way better, because you don't expect it. Yeah, you're gonna get eaten. Why would you do this to that beast? Yeah, let's put some... Let's just bane up this Rancor.
That's not good.
Find a way to stop the mutated Rancor. Weapons are useless against it. Good to know. Yeah. Getting some good high ground here. Will this actually kill me? Nope. But it's gonna hurt a lot. Okay. Also, I'm out of force juice. Not in the best mood right now. Oh, I guess I can steer the thing here? Oh, I'm sorry, you're actually like... Just go away. Oh, he's actually spitting bad stuff. That's not good. I actually don't remember how this level goes, but I guess we'll find out. So we've got angry cultist, we've got Rancor, we've got cultist, we've got Jedi, who could ask for anything more? Oh. Sorry to interrupt your dancing, buddy. Okay, good. Aw, oh, god damn it. Checkpoint dead. Checkpoint. Okay. Yeah, pretty much. Let's try again. Checkpoint. Yeah, see? Not so fun now, is it? Okay, there's a lot of enemies. There's a big beast on the loose. Not having the best day. Oh, nice! He just jumped to his death. I was so far down, he's like, I'm gonna get you, and then he just fell and died. You should probably not be standing next to that thing. I think that thing might explode. But you do you. I'm going over there. Yeah, folks, I mean, we all kind of lost there. Oh wow, he runs fast. Yeah, subtitles that ruin comedic timing also bad. Like, it's... Subtitling is an art. Okay, I just really need to be going. Oh, right. It actually hurts. I can heal on the go now. That's right. This is useful. No. Yeah, dark side. Folks, daylight's burning here. You've got a giant beast chasing us. You might want to look into that. Hope you're not going to get too tuckered out from running all the way there. Gosh, they went down. See, I still don't really know what happens in this game. Like, what makes it so that sometimes an enemy will go down super quickly, sometimes they won't. Can I jump that? I can jump that. Awesome. Stop. Or my mom will shoot.
You can't get away.
Now watch me.
Let's see what you've got.
See, I'm getting away pretty handily. There's something I kind of want to demonstrate. I wonder if I can do it here. Okay, see? Kind of wiped out hard. This was too high for me. But, if you remember, I can wall jump now. So let's see if I can do this. Nope. Messed it up. I just saved again. Well, I'll show this another time. Okay, you're just gone all red and nasty.
You can't escape.
Hey, Ramsey. We're just trying to, like, contain a giant Rancor. Not having the best time of it, to be perfectly honest. Oh, nice. Okay, he's just happy to run over there. I like how I can pretty much just ignore enemies and, well, not, okay. I cannot just pretty much ignore enemies. They will actually chase me down and kill me. But I do like that. I'm having some success.
Maybe I could trap it between those containers and the door.
Yep, that's what I'm gonna do. Okay, so I think I bring it here, and then... Oh, secret area. Yay! Excuse me. Just gonna... try to not get eaten. Thank you. Oh, buddy. Buddy, you are... we are kind of in a bind. This is not the time for our petty little grievances.
You won't get far.
What? Come on! Okay, well... we're... you know, giant mutated Rancor, not sure if you're aware, we have a situation here. You're doing all these tumbly bits, it's getting kind of annoying. Thank you. Gosh. Or you could just kill me, I mean, that's what you want to do. This is Star Wars Jedi Knight, Jedi Academy. One of my favorites. Like, level design is way better than... if you, like, imagine if this is your only contact with the, Jedi Knight games. Like, this is some of the best level design that series has to offer. Because the other level design was like... Most of the other games I got hopelessly lost in constantly. Levels were huge, sprawling, really hard to get around. Please don't do that. There's no need. Ow! Oh, that was mean! Just like doing this to- okay, this- I need to quick save at some point. This is not all I play. I play a bunch of different stuff. This is just like a bit of a long game. Basically, I do design delves, which is I play through a game and dig into its game design.
Maybe I could trap it between those containers and the door.
And Jedi Academy in particular has some really cool things. One I've been trying to show off in this level, but it's been a bit hard to find the right spot for it, but you know. It's also been interesting to kind of see how combat, especially like Sith combat, has really started to get way more acrobatic and interesting. Yep, Jedi, that's me. One down. There's another one, right? Right. Ow! Okay, well that worked. God. Where is the beastie? Did I forget to lure it here? Was I actually too efficient in escaping from it? The heck is it? Oh, there it is! Kinda lost track of me. I'm here! There we go. Just waiting, you know. Oh, this thing. I guess I'll back up. This isn't how conveyor belts work, by the way. You can't actually just back up like that. And crushed.
Jaden, we think these cultists were planning on releasing that mutated rancor into the city and using the ensuing chaos to steal supplies, credits, and whatever else they could get their hands on. Good work.
I don't think that's a good plan. Like this, do this great big thing, and in the ensuing chaos, do that. No, like, usually releasing this great big thing is the plan. Like, it's not just like, oh, we'll mutate a rancor and try to contain it, and then release it in the hopes that the chaos will let us do, like, these petty crimes. I don't know.
I've been trying to find out what Tavion could be hoping to do with Ragnos' scepter, but so far no luck. Keep your ears open for any rumors.
Will do. Okay. Dismantle device. Planet Yalara. Peaceful, primitive species, not ready to be integrated into galactic society. Okay, basically, prime directive, aliens, we set up a station hiding ourselves, and someone else has discovered it, and we probably, like, should be careful about that cloaking device.
That cloaking device is too powerful to fall into the wrong hands, cult or otherwise. It may be better to just destroy it.
Yep, destroy cool things, that's what I do. That's pretty much my job description. I never really did use those big guns. Oh hey, these are the aliens and they're in a threatening attack, threatening position. I guess I'm gonna fight them. God, I love that ship. It's my favorite ship. Well, almost like. Favorite ship? Probably Mayan Zarya. Second favorite ship, the Z95 Headhunter. Alright, yep, we got time for one more mission. Hey, it's a dam. Like, this is actually a pretty cool looking dam. Oh, hello. Alright, they have poison weapons. That is so not fun. Okay, well. Am I gonna have to kill you, I guess? Sorry. I'm really sorry. Also, their poison gas kind of goes through shields, which is pretty bad. That choking sound, you will hear it a lot. This is all you will hear throughout this entire mission, which is kind of a bummer. Sorry, equal opportunity destroyer here. Just want a shooting to stop. I do apologize. How is he back there? I'm really sorry. I wish there was a peaceful option. Please stop attacking me. I said please. I almost said, you know, God. Sometimes this game gets gruesome, and also look at that animation. Where'd your frames go, buddy? How does this even happen? Okay, I'm guessing I have to turn the... What the hell is this? I'm guessing I have to turn off this fan. Nope. Okay, so I came from there. I need to go here. Oh, okay, I can just take the elevator. Right, yeah, no one can swim. They just automatically die as soon as they enter the water. Oh, congratulations, you survived. Ah, there we go. And I like that this switch is just like broken, and that's why you can't stop the other one. I love this move so much, it's just like so artsy. Oh. Look at the size of this button. This button is bigger than my head. Oh crap! Oh my gosh, did I really not save? I'm the worst. Look at this button! It's bigger than my head. Now it's actually, like, not as big as my head, because my head is, like, this giant pancake. Yeah, just run away. Goodbye. Oh no, you can totally see him there. He just stops moving. Yeah, he's still there. Still in the water. Yep, just hanging out there in the water. Can you swim? No, he's just like chilling in the water. Oh no, he died. Oh my gosh, they're actually drowning. That's the worst thing. Okay. Gonna be a bit smarter about this now. I just always forget to save. Old games, well, old, you know. Games just when saving was starting to become a thing. Because of course there was a time when you never saved, there was passwords. And at some point, save technology kind of started to be a thing. But we didn't really know how to do it. It's kind of like the interface in some games. Okay. Save. Pushed it back away. Yeah, Force Lightning is pretty powerful. Oh, I'm sorry, there was someone else left. Isn't that cool? Like, that's a neat effect. Someone spent time on this, and I really appreciate it. Whee! Ow. Whee! Ow. Oh, that looks dangerous. It's very dangerous, see? Gosh! Electrocuted or, like, fell from great heights. Up to you, I guess. Oh gosh, no, no. Bad combination. Alright. That foot has some major support. Thank you. Reminding me to save. Oh crap, there's another one. Ow. Could one of you please fall? Kind of in a bad spot there, buddy. He did try, though. Gotta give it to him. Whee! Yeah, at this point, Stormtrooper is not a great challenge. Okay, if that guy had killed me, I would have been pretty embarrassed. Gosh. Okay, I think this is a good place to demonstrate something. So, remember, we have a wall jump now. Phew. This cool looking thing. If I just drop down here, I just lounge quietly on the ground. But, if I jump down here, okay, I'm gonna get it. If I jump down here... Okay, okay. This thing is kind of preventing me from doing the wall jump. Why you gotta make things so difficult? Is there a better one from the other? Because I really want to demonstrate this is actually a cool thing. Oh, nope. This is might be too far. Okay. They really don't want me to show this. Also, it's weird that I can't... Maybe 5 speed. Nope, I just fall down even quick. Oh, maybe from this side. Okay, from this place it might work. Okay, I'm supposed to be able to wall jump here. This is just gonna be me, like, falling. I used to be able to do this. What is the problem? Oh, maybe I need to, like, actually jump into it. Well, okay, I need to actually, like, have the... See? Wall jump. Splat. Let's show that again. Wall jump. Okay. Actual wall jump this time. Okay, hit my head on the corner there. This is actually really tricky to show off. Just need to get up. I'm gonna get it. Okay. Somewhere it's like someone is looking like, what the hell are you doing? Always just like jump. Like this is the thing, like they as I fall to my death multiple times. This feature, the wall jump, I'm guessing was added like... It doesn't feel like a core feature. It feels like something that was added like, oh, these are the cool thing you should be able to do, but you don't get a lot of use out of it. And this isn't like the best... Whoops. Okay, that one's on me. But... Yeah, it's like, oh, it's weird, like, sometimes. Oh, you're right, it could just be that it has to work on the side there. Which is weird. Maybe it's a term of angle. Anyway, I'm not going to spend too long on this, but you kind of saw that. Like, I can totally wall jump from great heights. And it's really cool when you pull it off. But wall jumping, though it looks nice and kind of looks like it resets your vertical momentum, doesn't actually do anything for it. Like, it's the game only... The game really didn't like that. Wow, did the game just break? Okay, something's wrong. What if I just quit the game and started over? The game really didn't want me to show that thing. Okay, here we are. Nice. Good. Good. At some point, the game just gave up, says, no, no, stop killing yourself. I won't have it anymore. But yeah, it's like, It's arcane, but the basic thing about it is, even though they make it so hard to actually find a spot where you can demonstrate it, that there is a cool wall jump you can do, like this one. And though this clearly shouldn't kill me, it totally does. Because the game, like, it's like when you're throwing enemies, at some point they know they're gonna die, and then they just immediately start their, ah, because that's cooler. So this game has that too. And that's just messed up, game, okay? That was kind of uncalled for. It's like, yeah, wall jump, cool, and then nope, you're still dead. Because it's taking into account your feet left the ground here. So if you touch down below this point, you die. Even if you do this cool wall jump where, by all means, you're stopped. You're still, like, you can do a giant wall jump. Like, go, whee, splat. Because that's how the game works, which makes the wall jump, admittedly, less useful. To be fair, I'm not sure what kind of recovery I would have if I just, like, landed there and didn't die, but it's still weird that this is how the game works. Can't stop. Ouch! Okay, I'm just... Oh, there's a bunch of you. There's a whole lot of you. Okay, maybe rush, like, this is, again, more... This game is like Dark Souls, because you shouldn't rush into battle. But now I'm just curious. Curious. Can I just, like... Yeah, I'll just let them work it out. Oh, I can just actually just leave. Shh. Really doesn't want to get yanked off the edge. Probably should have just taken the elevator. Let's do that. Or not, I guess. Whee! But... Isn't, like, despite its little foibles, little quirks, this game is fun and looks cool, and basically the goal of the game is, I want to be, like, a badass Jedi, and you totally get that. I'll just take my leave. Okay, good. I guess I have to put some blow-ups things over here. I should also heal. I was just carrying this thing that's bigger than me. But, like, make no mistake. Doing this is really cool. And I'm okay that they put it in the game, even though it doesn't... Darth Vader used many Nogri. Ah, skip the cutscene. Imagine this thing blew up.
About the Yularens and guard the cloaking device. Now that the device is destroyed, no one can claim it. The remaining Nogri have been picked up and returned home.
Okay, so these haven't been Yularens. They were Nogri, which were other types of aliens that were fighting the Imperials for some reason. Well...
We haven't received any new reports about cult activity in the last few days, but I don't think they've decided to go into hiding. they must be close to completing their plan.
Yeah, that leader, the way she spoke, didn't really look like someone who would go into hiding. Alright, so we have these two. We should probably... You know what? I will cut for the archive and then keep going. So, just a moment. If you're watching this in the archive, stay tuned for the next episode because I probably uploaded it along with this one. Because why wouldn't I? So, see you in a minute. You're wonderful.